What kind of girl is Wanda? What kind of person is she? If you have to describe Wanda in a few words, what would you say? She is one of those persons, the one who is introvert, the one who doesn't speak much, but she is not the one who is lagging behind in anything. So now we are going to talk about a competition. So far, all these girls have always been considering this Wanda as one who is very poor or the one who needs, who doesn't have anything, this or that. But now, after this competition, their viewpoint will change. And that will also help us gather the value that nothing matters. What matters the most is our merit, our qualities, our talent, our skills, our qualities. Okay, whatever the best is in us, no one can take it away from us. Okay? And instead of answering what people are saying, instead of reacting to what people say against us, what we should do? We should prove our mettle to our action. The best way to respond to somebody is prove yourself. That's it. That is what civilization is about. Okay? Let's see now. Today, even though they had been late to school, Magnesius.
Ma'am, your voice is not clearly audible.
What can I do?
The microphone.
Now is it better?
No.
You're on page number 67. So is it better?
Yes, ma'am, better.
I'll be holding it like this. So even though they had been late to school, Maddie was glad she had not had to make fun of Wanda. She worked her arithmetic problems absent-mindedly. So, Saharsh, why did Maddie do her arithmetic problems absent-mindedly? Why did Maddie do her arithmetic problems absent-mindedly? Who is Maddie? You tell me this. Who is Maddie? Come on. How many characters are there in this story? You tell me this. Name three major characters of the story. Okay. That's it. Yes, beta, you tell. Wanda, yes, Wanda, Maddie, and Maddie. So these are the three main characters of the story. There are many other students, but we know the names of these children. Okay, these three are, two are best friends. Who are the best friends? Maddie and Paddy are best friends. Why are they best friends? How can we say that they are best friends? Are they really best friends? You tell me, like, how do we say, why do we say, why do they feel they are the best friends? Divita, you tell.
Janvi. She is poor, that's why they are best friends. My question is, how do we think, why do we think that they are best friends, or even they think they are best friends? You know? So why is it so? Yes. What makes us feel that they are best friends? What makes us feel? Yes, that's the point. Yes, correct, Tarundi. Both of them are always together. So they think, and even we think, they are best friends. But the fact, is it really so? Are they really best friends? So they are not the best friends because Paddy wants to talk to Maddie, or Maddie wants to talk to Maddie wants to talk to Paddy about something. But she is not able to. Are the best friends like this? The best friends are the one, those who are free to talk to each other. Those who don't mind telling each other their weaknesses. Good friends are not the one, those who keep on pampering you. Now, wow, you are great. You look awesome. Good friends are the ones, those who tell like you look horrible. So you must change your way. This is not done. Why you did this? So that is being a good friend. When you are able to tell your friend the weaknesses as well. So these two girls were not good friends because one was not able to tell the other what she wanted to say. Got it? And now the thing is, what did Maddie want to talk to Paddy about? Yes. Maddie wanted to tell Paddy that they should that she should not tease Wanda. Now the question is, have you got your laptop with you? Have you got your device with you? You can listen to me online. Both offline and online you can have together. Even then, what will happen? Output will be zero. It's all up to us whether we want to make the most of the opportunities or we want to waste it. If your parents manage to manage your uniform, your tiffin, your bag, your bottle, you had to manage only your books. That you did not manage. When you came to school, what did you think? You're going for a picnic? You should have got your book with you. Then take your book from him. Take it. But they are very good friends. Is it good friendship that you give your book to him and you tell him, you study, let me waste my time? Is it good friendship? Poor friendship. Okay, so same words for you, Himanshu, now. No? Anyways. So 8 times 8. Let's see. She wished she had the nerve to write Paddy a note. What do you mean by to, she had, if she had the nerve to say something? She had the courage. She wished she had the courage to tell her friend that she should not make fun of Wanda. Hey, Peg, let's stop asking Wanda how many dresses she has. When she finished her arithmetic, she did start a note to Paddy. Suddenly, she paused and shuddered. She pictured herself in the schoolyard, a new target for Paddy and the girls. Paddy might ask her where she got the dress that she had on, and Maddie would have to say it was one of Paddy's old ones that Maddie's mother had tried to disguise with new trimmings, so no one in room 13 would recognize it. So Maddie wanted to talk to Maddie about, she wanted to talk to her friend Paddy about the fact like they should not tease Wanda. She was about to start writing the note, but suddenly she was shuddered. She trembled at the very thought, like maybe her friend would come to know that she was also wearing her friend's old dress, which her mother had mended. Her mother had mended it so nicely, so tactfully, that now no one was able to recognize that it was one of Peggy's old dress. But because of this, she realized that maybe somebody would tease her. So this thought made her stop writing the note. She stopped writing the note for her friend. Now the question is, there can be many questions, but I'll be asking you one simple question. Why did Maddie stop writing note which was meant for her friend Paddy? Nana, yes, one child, Nana. Because she was afraid. Explain it. You won't get marks like this. Come here and speak. Your friends might also be willing to see, like, who is there.
She was afraid to be the next target of Peggy. She thought that if she would complain her or tell her not to do this, she would have gone angry and she would start bullying Maddie. But she's also not very rich. No.
Yes, well done. Literature, we always say, is life. Right? So whatever we read over here, they all come from somewhere or the other from this situations. Okay, it's not that the things are always written there. We have to draw the inferences. You know, we have to draw the conclusions from what we see all around us. So this time, this girl, Maddie, was afraid that maybe her secret would be exposed. She would be exposed. Because she was also poor and she was also wearing one of the old dresses of her friend. So if she would tell her friend not to do something, then maybe she would tease her also. So this made her stop writing a note for her friend. Okay. And moreover, children, it takes guts, courage to tell somebody what one should do. Right. So if only Peggy would decide of her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda. If only Peggy would decide of her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda. What does it mean? So let me ask somebody online. Yes, Thavlesh, speak up. Give the meaning of this line.
Yes, ma'am. Repeat.
Explain first line of if only Peggy would decide of her own accord to stop having fun with Wanda. What does it mean?
Only.
Yes.
Peggy decided that she would not make fun of Wanda.
If only means that she wished that Peggy should decide on her own not to tease Wanda. Maddie wanted to tell her not to do this, but she could not. She did not have the courage to tell her like this. And she wanted Peggy should do this on her own. Got it? The line, if only Peggy would decide. What does it mean that she wanted that she should do this on her own? It is the wish of Maddie. Okay? So when you wish something, what do you say? If only she does it on her own. If only she would go there. Kaash wo wahan jaye. Okay? It's your wish. Oh, well, Maddie ran her hand through her short blonde hair as though to push the uncomfortable thoughts away. So Maddie was thinking about all these things. So she let her hands run through her blonde hair. Blonde, you know, brown hair. Hai na? The English people have got blonde hair. Your Barbie dolls might have all got blondes. Nowadays, the Indian Barbies are also there. So, but I'm not talking about Indian Barbies. I'm talking about the other ones. So, oh, well, Maddie ran her hand through her short blonde hair as though to push the uncomfortable thoughts away. So, when you do something like this, oh my God, what do? Whatever is inside you, beat that. So her gesture of running her hands through her hair was letting her thoughts get dispelled. Slowly, Maddie tore into bits the note she had started. So she tore off the paper where she had started writing a note for Peggy. She was Peggy's best friend, and Peggy was the best liked girl in the whole room. Peggy could not possibly do anything that was really wrong, she thought. Very important line. She was the best friend of her friend, Peggy, Maddie thought. And Peggy is the most favored girl of the class. She was liked by everybody. So she will not do something which will make her draw criticism. When you are the favorite of everybody, then you will take care that no one criticizes you. Isn't it? This is what Maddie thought. Maddie thought like her friend is very, famous, favorite of everyone. So that way, maybe she would stop doing this because she would not like to be criticized. Got it? And it's a fact. So if you want to be famous, if you want to be liked by everybody, you'll have to do the things which others like. Hello? As for Wanda, she was just some girl, just the same girl who lived up on Boggins Heights. Just some girl who lived up on Boggin Heights and stood alone in the schoolyard. So she scarcely ever said anything to anybody. The only time she talked was in the schoolyard about her 100 dresses. Maddie remembered her telling about one of her dresses, pale blue with colored trimmings. And she remembered another that was brilliant jungle green with a red sash. You would look like a Christmas tree in that, the girls had said in a pretended admiration. So as for Wanda, what kind of girl she was? So as far as Wanda is concerned, she was the one. So what did they knew of Wanda? As far as Wanda is concerned, they only knew that she lived in Boggin Heights and she did not speak much. And once only she said like she had 100 dresses. And at second time, she said like she had a green colored dress also. At the time, the other girls mockingly pointed out that she would look like a Christmas tree. And that was a very pretentious compliment. Sometimes you praise somebody not because you praise the person, but because you want to make fun of that person. This is what those girls were doing. Okay? Okay, thinking about Wanda and her 100 dresses all lined up in the closet, Maddie began to wonder who was going to win the drawing and coloring contest. For girls, this contest consisted of designing dresses, and for boys, of designing motorboats. Probably Peggy would win the girls' medal, and Peggy drew better than anyone else in the room. So then when this girl, Maddie, was thinking about the competition, about Wanda, she started thinking about the competition and she was sure what kind of competition it was. It was a contest painting competition in which the girls were supposed to paint dresses and the boys were supposed to paint motorboats. And this Maddie was sure that Peggy would win because she was very good in painting. She was rather best in painting, she thought. So this is what actually happens in our society. What happens in our society? Many a times we people have preconceived judgment. We people have preconceived ideology Like only that child might have done the best. Okay, if some child has been doing best for years, we take it for granted like that child might be the best only. Okay, many a time somebody else is not acknowledged. It's a human psychology. But that's not true. That's not good. Everybody should be evaluated and this will be done. But that is, this kind of, conception happens only amongst the immature people. Mature people don't do this. Okay, mature people are not carried over by the looks. They go beyond. So in the end, the school judgment will be right. But these are immature children. So Maggie is not mature, Maddie. So Maddie is of the opinion that Peggy is best. Okay? So she would only win the competition. Peggy drew better than anyone else in the room. At least that's what everybody thought. She could copy a picture in a magazine or some film star's head so that you could almost tell who it was. So what was the reason that Maddie thought that Peggy was best? This is a reason. I'll be asking you this later on. So underline that, like, why did she think that she was best? So Saharsh, keep your answer ready after some time. So she could keep a picture in a magazine or some film star's head so that you could almost tell who it was. Oh, Maddie was sure Peggy would win. Well, tomorrow the teacher was going to announce the winners, then they would know. The next day it was drizzling. Maddie and Peggy hurried to school under Peggy's umbrella. Naturally, on a day like this, they didn't wait for Wanda Petronsky on the corner of Oliver Street. The street that far, far away under the railroad tracks and up the hill led to Boggins Heights. Anyway, they weren't taking chances on being late today because today was important. So why was it an important day? Because the results of painting competition were going to be announced and they did not wait for Wanda. Why did they wait for Wanda, Himanshu? These girls used to wait for Wanda every day. Why did they wait for her? Come on. Yes, come on. Saharsh? Why did the girls wait for Wanda at Oliver Street? Yes, you tell beta. What's your name? Okay, Aryansh. Why did they wait for Wanda? Daily they used to wait for her. Then what would they do when Wanda would come? They would make fun of her. They would tease her. Okay? They would wait for her to tease her. One more question from this. Did Wanda used to get teased? No, she never bothered. Rather, she never realized that she was being teased. She never realized this. Do you have an answer like why didn't she realize that people were teasing her? Can you tell me like why did she think, why didn't she come to know that she was being teased? Come on. Anyone here online? Why did she think? Raise hand if you know. Yes, Ruhani.
Ma'am, because she was not saying a lie actually, it was a truth, and at the end of the story we come to know that she was actually having 100 races.
Okay, yes, correct answer. So even if you've not read the end of the story, even then you can make out like if she was not getting cheesed off because of the way the other girls used to ask her the questions. She didn't get affected because she was genuine. What she was saying, she was real. If she was not telling a lie, then how could she feel that the others were not getting her? Okay? If I say I have this, but if you don't believe it, how would I come to know that you are not believing it? Unless and until I am very crafty also. Okay? And I am. We have to be. Okay. Where I was? Drizzling color done? Okay. Okay. Do you think Miss Mason will announce the winners today? Asked Peggy. Who is Miss Mason? Teacher. Oh, I hope so. The minute we get in, said Maddie. Of course, you'll win, Peg. Hope so, said Peggy. The minute they entered the classroom, they stopped short and gasped. What is gasped? Breathless. There were drawings all over the room on every ledge and windowsill. Dazzling colors and brilliant, lavish designs, all drawn on great sheets of wrapping paper. There must have been 100 of them all lined up. These must be the drawings for the contest. They were. Everybody stopped and whistled or murmured admiringly. So the moment they entered the class, they were taken aback. They were surprised. And they forgot to breathe also. And then they saw that all around the room, on every ledge, on every windowsill, that there were paintings of beautiful designs of the dresses. And there were about hundreds of paintings, you can say. There were 100 paintings and they were all lined up. And they were all of different dazzling colors, shining colors. And everybody, you know, all the students, children who saw the paintings, they all started admiring them. As soon as the class had assembled, Miss Mason announced the winners. Jack Bagels had won for the boys, she said. And his design for an outboard motor was an exhibition in room 12, along with the sketches by all the other boys. So who had won from the boys' side? Jack Bagels. And his painting had been kept in the other room, number 12. So which room was this where they were? 13. As for the girls, she said, although just one or two sketches were submitted by most, one girl and room 13 should be proud of her. This one girl actually drew 100 designs, all different and all beautiful. In the opinion of the judges, any one of the drawings is worthy of winning the prize. And I'm very happy to say that Wanda Petronsky is a winner of the girls' medal. So all the girls drew either one design or two. But one girl had made about 100 paintings. And all of them were worth winning prizes. Each painting was worth of winning a prize. And so the contest was won by Wanda Petronsky. She did not win that because she had made 100 paintings. She won because her each painting was worth of a prize. Okay, somebody might feel that maybe if I had made 100 paintings, then even I might have won. No, each painting was qualitative. Okay, so quality doesn't matter. Sorry, quantity doesn't matter. Quality matters. Okay. You may be asked in an MCQ, like, did Wanda win because she had made 100 dresses? The answer will be no. She won because her all paintings were worth of it. Got it? There can be any vocabulary related to the question, but you should know the main point. Unfortunately, Wanda has been absent from school for some days and is not here to receive the applause that is due to her. What is applause? Appreciation. So that applause or the appreciation which she deserves, She is not getting it because she is not there and she has not been coming for the last some days. Let us hope she will be back tomorrow. Now, class, you may file around the room quietly and look at her exquisite drawings. What is exquisite? Extremely beautiful, well crafted. The children burst into applause, and even the boys were glad to have a chance to stamp on the floor, put their fingers in their mouths and whistle, though they were not interested in dresses. So even the boys were happy to appreciate such great composition or craft. "Look, Peg," whispered Maddie. "There is that blue one she told us about. Isn't it beautiful?" "Yes," said Peggy. "And there is that green one, boy. And I thought I could draw." Got it? So now, what does it mean, "I thought I could draw"? She wished that she could also draw such beautiful drawings. Okay, children, the time is over. So do the questions related to this chapter today. And just to do these questions, last four questions on the notebook. Rest you just orally prepare. Then do all the exercises on the book itself.